Hi, my name is Anwar. I'm a designer, a developer, and a teacher at Treehouse. My pronouns are he, him. In this workshop, we'll be discussing responsive design, where content renders well and remains usable on a variety of devices and viewport sizes. On previous projects, you may have been asked to design with a specific screen in mind, whether a desktop, tablet, or mobile device. And sometimes, especially when designing for a mobile app, this approach can be appropriate. For websites, however, it's usually best to work with a single design and consider how that design transitions from screen to screen. Here's a gallery of award-winning responsive websites. Let's check some out to see what they have in common. CSS Tricks is a great resource for articles on web development and design. On a larger screen, columns of body copy move to the side to make room for ad banners. But on mobile, the banners disappear and the body copy occupies the entire screen. There's not much room for navigation on a mobile screen, so the tab bar gets hidden behind a menu icon, and the search bar is replaced by a single icon that can show or hide the search input with a tap. The personal site of Ethan Marcotte is featured here as well. His site has a lot in common with CSS Tricks. The columns of body copy on the larger screen move towards the middle and make room for white space, while they again occupy the entire screen on mobile. And while Ethan's navigation is smaller and lacks a search feature, it once again gets collapsed under a menu icon on a mobile screen. It's no surprise that Ethan Marcotte's site is featured in a gallery of responsive websites. Marcotte is credited with coining the term responsive design in an article for A List Apart back in 2010. Marcotte identified three components as key to creating a responsive website. Fluid grids. On phones, there is only room for one column of body copy, which extends all the way across the screen. On tablet and desktop screens, designers can base their designs on a multi-column grid layout that can expand or contract based on the width of the device. Flexible images. Images should expand or contract along with your responsive grid. Media queries. Media queries are CSS rules that get implemented under certain conditions. For example, you might want to switch from a one-column layout to a multi-column version only when the screen is wider than 600 pixels. When media queries are used to change site layout based on device width, this is known as a breakpoint. Typically, designers and developers will start with a mobile layout. A mobile design might look great at 320 pixels, but let's say that by 600 pixels, the columns of body copy have grown too wide for optimum legibility. 600 pixels would be considered the breakpoint. Any devices wider than 600 pixels would see a different version of the design. From there, we could keep expanding the design until it breaks again. At 960 pixels, we might have room for a column of advertisements that didn't fit on a smaller viewport. 960 pixels becomes the next breakpoint where the design changes again. I mentioned that it's usually best to solve for mobile screens first. This has a few benefits. Solving for a smaller screen first helps you identify what content is most critical. You might have decorative elements or sidebar information that works fine on a larger screen, but can be omitted from mobile view. Loading only what's absolutely necessary on a mobile screen means your mobile version will load faster. mobile users are typically only willing to wait about 3 seconds for the primary page content to load before bailing out. Finally, since fitting navigation schemes onto a small screen is a tough task, working mobile-first forces you to solve complex navigation challenges right away.